Senator Morris, if you were a food, what would you be and why?
When we were kids and there were four girls, we ate whatever our parents put on the table. That's what you did when you were growing up. But once a year, when it was your birthday, you would get to choose what food you were going to eat. And you would get to do the whole menu. And I can't really remember what the entrees were. But every year, we would go out. And they used to be drive-ins, the A&W root beer drive-ins. And we would have root beer floats for my birthday. So I would be a root beer float. So I could come out with
it. Thank you.
So I'm really intimidated. You have some great stories that have been telling. And mine is just starts with food, but it really takes us to the people that we serve here at Community Action Partnership. About 2 years ago, a family came in to get food, and that's not unusual. At Anaheim Independencia, we do probably 500 families a month we serve food to. And it was a father and a mother, and they had an 18-year-old and a 15-year-old, two sons, and an 8-year-old daughter. And it wasn't, as I said, anything unusual. Many of our families need food, and even though the father works and the mother works, they still struggle. Well, in November, about 6 months later, the mother came back, and she was recovering from surgery. She had had mouth cancer, and they had removed part of her jaw. And because it was so devastating, the cancer and the loss of her jaw, her husband freaked out and left her. And her son, who was 18, was attending community college. And less than a week after the father left, he quit school and went to work to take care of the family. Well, this was the family that we adopted about 2 years ago. We adopted them because we give holiday assistance each year, and we see about 400 families, and we provide them gifts for their kids and food for the family. But we only do it for kids 12 and under because that's who people give gifts to. They think little kids are wonderful, and they forget that there's this other group of kids that are amazing kids. So this family was obvious. My staff came to me, we have to take care of this family. And our adoptive family program is a little different than the other holiday family program. We find a sponsor, a company, or a family. We ask them to assist every single family member, to give them a gift and a piece of clothing and a basket for food. And we did this because we know that there are times that special families need special care. They need to know that what they're doing is courageous. It was great, wonderful to help the family. The boy was doing everything he could, but they came back about 3 months later because they couldn't hold the apartment that they had been in because it was just too much. The two parents had been working, she was still recovering, and he had a job, but it wasn't enough. The family interviewed for us with our new long-term supportive housing program. It's a program we have where we allow families to pay $1,100 for a three-bedroom house, which is really, in Orange County, a wonderful thing to do. And they qualified, and the story goes that we were able not just to give them food when they came in or help them at the holidays, but to give them hope and to give them a chance to rebuild their lives. When they moved in, the mother had gone back. They reconstructed her jaw. She was back at work. They were both working. We talked to him about what he wanted to do, and he said what he wanted to do was make sure his brother graduated from high school, and maybe he could go to college. And he said, after they get stable, maybe he could figure out how to go back to college himself, because the two of them together had a dream that they would start their own shop, a mechanic shop, when they grew up. So I wanted to tell you about the adoptive family program. Certainly not the same humor that all of you had, but certainly is heartwarming and a story of hope. Thank you. Mm-hmm.